Only 28 days out from the election, and women voters, particularly those in the suburbs, are considered key to winning the White House. And an op-ed in the New York Post highlights some of the suburban moms and suburban women who might help President Trump win the election. And we are joined by two of them. We have Christina Sagmar. She's a Pennsylvania voter, and Carla Muller. She's a Wisconsin voter. Hey, ladies.
Hi.
Good morning.
Hi.
Good morning. Good morning. So, Christina, tell the folks at home your story. I know it because we've been chatting during the commercial break, but you grew up as a Democrat, right? Your parents, your grandparents. Why are you now a Republican?
Well, my grandfather came here as a legal immigrant from Yugoslavia, and, you know, he was in the union because he worked for the steel mill. And unions always supported the Democratic Party, so my family was Democrat. As time went on, I started to have a closer relationship to God, and I started to realize my morals and values were more of what the Republican Party was. And then when I met my husband and his family, they are very strong Republicans and very conservative family, I started to realize that I was in the wrong party, and I changed to Republican.
So you'll be voting for President Trump?
Yes, I will be.
Okay, Carla, how about you? I know you almost did not vote for President Trump in 2016 because of his lack of a track record. Have you changed your mind? You obviously voted for him. Have you been happy with the job he's done?
Yes, he now has a track record. He has almost a 4-year track record. And before March, when the virus hit, the economy was doing so well, an excellent economic track record for President Trump, in my opinion.
Do you think
so?
Yes. Do you think he'll bring the economy back once we get over this pandemic?
Yes, I really think he can. I really think he can bring the economy back. And we need someone with the right policies to do that, because it really is a crisis right now.
Christina, what are your friends saying? Do you think that President Trump will win, or do you think it'll be close?
I think he will win. I really do. I think people will realize that he is who we need. We need a strong leader, and he will win.
Carla,
I definitely believe that.
Carla, what did you think about his message yesterday? He's gotten a lot of criticism.
Yes, well, you know, I have more to say about the criticism in a way. I was, you know, surprised by the media criticizing him for trying to take on the correct role of a leader to encourage us not to be afraid in this very difficult time. That is the classic leadership role that he took with his message. I think it was the right thing for him to do. And it's just an example of the media hysteria, how they spin it and they are constantly trying to campaign so that he doesn't win re-election in November. And so they spun it in a negative way. But I thought it was an excellent approach to the current situation and to his, you know, release from the hospital and trying to encourage the American people.
Did you read any headlines?
Yes, this morning I had a glance at the New York Times website, and that is exactly what I'm referring to with media hysteria. I don't think the New York Times is credible at all. I mean, I can't believe the way they are constantly criticizing Trump, even when he, in my opinion, does the right thing as the leader of our country.
Christina, many are criticizing him for saying you're going to beat it when so many people weren't able to beat it. What are your thoughts?
I mean, you know, again, early on, unfortunately, we weren't sure what to do. And now we do know what to do. And thank goodness it was later that he developed this. And all the medications and everything have helped him. And I think it was great his speech yesterday. It shows what a strong leader he is. And it's what we need. I think it made us, you know, made me feel better about the whole situation.
Okay.
Dealing with the coronavirus.
So Alex Berenson, who used to write for the New York Times, Carla, you'll be happy to hear you're in line with him, because he did agree. He said it was maybe the smartest comment that the president has ever made. He liked his strength and his leadership yesterday. Ladies, thank you so much. And Christina, I know you pray, and you were telling me during the commercial break you've been praying for the president, and Melania appreciates your prayers. She tweeted out, grateful for the prayers, feeling good, continuing to rest at home. Ladies, thank you. God bless you both and your children.
God bless you, too. Thank you, Ainsley.
Thank you.